Hi everyone, today I'm going to run through a few of the possible setups for the Skookum Robotics SK-PB1 Powerbus. The Powerbus can be used in a number of configurations, and today I'm going to walk through the most commonly used ones. The Powerbus is designed to allow you to power your high voltage servos directly from an 8.4 volt 2S LiPo battery. You can also run a mix of high and low voltage servos using the same 2S LiPo battery and a BEC. Right out of the package, you'll notice that there's no battery connector attached to the power bus. You need to solder a battery connector that fits the power source you're using for your heli to the 18-gauge silicon wire. I'm going to start by showing you how the power bus is connected to the SK720 when using a satellite or S-bus receiver. The four included jumper cables are connected to the bus A, B, C, and D ports on the back of the power bus. Bus A is connected vertically into the tail port. Bus B is connected horizontally across the top pins for SWL, R, and C, with the negative wire connected to SWL, the positive wire to SWR, and the signal wire to SWC. Bus C is also connected to the SK720 horizontally, into the IOB, IOA, and SWA ports. Like bus B, it's connected on the top row of pins with the negative wire on the left and the signal wire on the right. Bus D is connected vertically to IOD with IOC left open for an RPM sensor. For a setup using all high voltage servos, connect the servos to the same ports as you would on the SK720. The port names are identical, though the order on the servo bus is slightly different. You'll notice that there's two tail ports on the power bus. For this high voltage setup, connect the tail to the port beside PWR-HV. Your ESC or throttle servo is connected on the upper rail of the power bus. In order to deliver the 8.4 volts to that servo, bridge the middle pins of the HV and LV ports with the included jumper plug, then connect the ESC or throttle servo. I'm now going to show a combination of high voltage and low voltage servos running off the same 2S 8.4 volt battery. Using high voltage swash servos, they're connected in the same place as we did in the last setup. Now, assuming we're using a lower voltage tail servo, we'll connect it to the top half of the power bus. The lower voltage is delivered to the top half of the bus via BEC. Plug the input into the power HV port and the output into the power LV port. The throttle is connected to IOAT as usual, and the tail servo into the low voltage tail port. If you're running entirely low voltage servos, connect the power bus directly to your 5 volt battery and connect your servos the same way you would as if you were running all high voltage servos. When it comes to connecting your S-bus or satellite receivers, there's no difference in the connection whether you're using the power bus or not. They're both connected in the SAT-RX port on the side of the SK720 using an S-bus adapter when necessary. Traditional receivers are connected directly to the SK720 as well. However, the receiver connections use the ports normally connected to bus C and D, so you won't be able to use the auxiliary ports on the power bus. For instructions on how to connect a traditional receiver to the SK720, watch our traditional receiver video. Finally, I'll show you how to use the soft switch power bus. Removing the jumper plug from the red and yellow wires sends power to the power bus. This function is useful if you'd like to power up your servos and the SK720 from outside the canopy. If you have questions regarding the power bus, the SK720, or any of the Skookum Robotics products, send us an email at info@skookumrobotics.com or check the wiki at skookumrobotics.com/wiki. Thanks for watching.